Hello students, welcome to Grade Up. I am Vikas Bhadoria and today in this class we are going to study about the topic of heat. In the previous lecture of thermodynamics we have covered first law of thermodynamics, and from first law of thermodynamics we have seen that the main consequence of first law of thermodynamics is the main outcome is that heat transfer is a path function. So today in this lecture we are going to study about heat and its interaction for different thermodynamics process. Okay. Now heat, there is a separate subject of heat transfer. Don't be confused that we are going to study heat transfer. Here we are only concerned about heat. What is heat? Right now you can see this, the temperature is soaring quite high, and you have to either be in the air conditioner or in some coolers. Okay, because there is so much heat outside. Okay. Why do you feel that heat? Due to temperature, high temperature. Okay, so heat is an energy which is due to temperature difference. Okay, or the energy transfer due to temperature difference is known as heat. Okay, so one important factor that is linked with heat is temperature. Okay. Okay, the more is the temperature, more will be heat of a system, right? So heat transfer, if we study energy transfer due to heat or heat transfer is proportional to temperature difference between two bodies. It is proportional to temperature difference between two bodies, okay? And also it is proportional to the mass between two bodies, the bodies which are in contact, the mass of the body. So heat is an energy transfer which takes place due to temperature difference. Okay, and if there is a law called law of calorimetry which say that this is equal to m dt, q is directly proportional to mass of the body and the temperature difference. Okay, if you remove this proportionality constant, you will get q is equal to mc dt. Q is equal to mc dt. This is known as law of calorimetry from calorimetry principle. You get that heat transfer is equal to mc dt. That means heat transfer between two bodies which are in contact is directly proportional to the temperature difference and the mass of the body. Okay, by removing the proportionality constant, you will get this C term. C is known as specific heat. What is specific heat? See, specific heat, the definition of specific heat is that it is that amount of heat which is used to increase the temperature of unit mass. If m is equal to 1, unit mass of a substance through 1 degree Celsius. What is the definition of specific heat? It is the amount of heat required to increase the temperature of unit mass of a substance through unit temperature degree. That means specific heat is a very important property, which is the amount of heat required to increase the temperature of unit mass. Unit mass means mass equal to 1 kg of a substance through unit temperature difference. Okay, that is the specific heat. Now, this specific heat is of two types. One is specific heat at constant pressure, another is specific heat at constant volume, which is denoted by Cp and Cv. This is at constant pressure and this is specific heat at constant, specific heat at constant volume. Okay, so this specific heat is of two types, specific heat at constant pressure and specific heat at constant volume. Okay, now what is the definition of these two specific heat? The definition of specific heat at constant pressure and volume is almost exactly similar to specific heat. Only difference is that specific heat at constant pressure is the amount of heat required to increase the temperature of unit mass of a substance through unit degree temperature difference at constant pressure. At constant pressure. If we add at constant pressure here, then this specific heat will become a specific heat at constant pressure. Then the definition of specific heat will become definition of specific heat at constant pressure. What is specific heat at constant volume? If this temperature difference at constant becomes constant volume, then this specific heat will become specific heat at constant volume. So, specific heat, if you know what is specific heat, the specific heat at constant pressure and volume are just same as specific heat, only is that condition of constant pressure and constant volume. Okay. So, these specific heat at constant pressure and volume are very, very important for thermodynamics. Let us see what is the relationship between specific heat at constant pressure and volume. Okay. Relationship between or relation between specific heat at constant pressure, specific heat Cp and Cv. What is the relationship between Cp and Cv? See, Cp minus Cv is equal to R. This is one relation, that is difference of two specific heat at constant pressure and constant volume is equal to gas constant, which is R. Okay, this is very, very important. Difference of specific heat is equal to gas constant. Okay, it is equal to gas constant. Next is ratio of specific heat, ratio of specific heat is given by gamma, which is equal to Cp over Cv. Ratio of the specific heat is equal to Cp over Cv. Okay, so these are very, very important thing. Now this gamma is different for different gases. Gamma depends on different gases. Okay, so for monoatomic gases, we know that ideal gases, they are either monoatomic or diatomic or polyatomic. So for monoatomic gases, this gamma value is equal to 1.67. For diatomic gases, this is equal to 1.4. And for polyatomic gases, that is gases which are having atoms more than 2, it is equal to 1.33. Okay. So, this is the value of gamma, that is adiabatic index. Gamma is called the adiabatic index. We have studied thermodynamic process in the previous lectures. So, there I have told you about what is gamma, that is adiabatic index. This gamma is equal to the ratio of specific heat at constant pressure over specific heat at constant volume, and the value of gamma is different for different type of gases. For monoatomic, it is equal to 1.67, for diatomic, it is equal to 1.4, and for polyatomic, it is equal to 1.33. Okay, so you have to remember these values because in the exam, maybe value will be given to you or maybe not. Okay, so you have to remember the values. For your reference, I want to tell you that most of the gases are diatomic in nature. If not given in the question, you have to take the value of gamma as 1.4, because most of the gases exist in the form of diatomic state. For example, oxygen, nitrogen, these are the gases. Basically, most of the gases are consist of oxygen and nitrogen, and oxygen, nitrogen both exist in diatomic state as an ideal gas. Okay, so if not given in the exam, if value of gamma is not given and you have to find the value of gamma, you can take it as 1.4. Okay, see, this value of Cp and Cv is having a relationship. If you combine these two equation 1 and 2, if you combine these two equation, we can get something. What is, from here Cp is equal to gamma times of Cv, right? And from here Cp is equal to R plus Cv. Okay, so you will get Cv is equal to R over gamma minus 1. From these two equation 1 and 2, you will get Cv is equal to R over gamma minus 1, and Cp is equal to gamma times of R over gamma minus 1. Okay, these are very, very important. These are very, very important relations. Okay, you have to remember these equations. Okay, they are very, very important. Okay, you should remember this equation, because in the exam it might be possible that value of Cp and Cv is not given to you, and value of gamma and R is given to you. Okay, so you have to, even value of R is not given to you. R you can calculate by, we know that R is equal to, this R is equal to R universal over molecular mass. Okay, molecular mass of most of the gases is equal to 29. For gases, molecular mass is equal to 29, and this value is equal to 8.314. So value of R is equal to almost 0.287. 0.287 is the value of R. Most of the time it is equal to 0.287, and value of gamma is 1.4. But if in not given in the exam and you have to calculate the value of Cp and Cv, you can use these equations. These equations are very, very important. Okay, one more important relation, that Cp is greater than Cv. This is also a very, very important relation, that is specific heat at constant pressure is greater than specific heat at constant volume. How it is greater? See, suppose that I take an example of a piston cylinder arrangement. Okay, and there what is happening? Compression of the gas is happening, gas is getting compressed. Okay, so in the piston cylinder arrangement, suppose that one process at constant pressure, heat addition is taking place at constant pressure here. Okay, right now piston is at here, at this point, bottom dead center. Okay, now other process is here, at constant volume. Here heat addition is taking place at constant volume, and here at constant pressure. Now when the heat will be added here, when heat will be supplied, in this case what will happen? First of all, at constant volume, I want to tell you that here there are two stoppers. Two stoppers are used. Why? What is the role of stoppers? The main role of stopper is that it will not allow the piston to move away from this position. Okay, so in the case of constant volume process, the boundary will not be, sorry, The stoppers will not be here, the stoppers will be here. The stoppers will be kept here, sorry, above the piston. So the piston motion is restricted. The heat transfer, the heat which is supplied is not able to do any work, because for a closed system work is said to be done when boundary is displaced. When boundary is displaced, then only work is said to be done. So in the constant volume process, no displacement of boundary, no displacement of boundary. So work will be equal to zero in case of constant volume process, right? So if work is equal to zero, all the heat which is supplied at constant volume will go into increasing the internal energy. It will increase the internal energy of the system, okay. But in this case, in the constant pressure process, the heat supplied will increase the energy, internal energy, but also do some work. Some work will be there due to displacement of the boundary. The piston will move from this position to this position, because here there are no stoppers. There are no stoppers here. Okay, so in that case, what will happen? The piston will move and boundary will displace. The boundary will displace and the work will be done. Work will be done by the system. So, tell me, here the heat which is supplied is doing two things. It is doing the work and also it is increasing the internal energy. But at constant volume, all the heat which is supplied is only increasing the internal energy. No work is done. So that's why specific heat at constant pressure is having more value at as compared to specific heat at constant volume, because here both internal energy and work is to be done with the help of heat. Here heat supplied is only increasing the internal energy. So that's why Cp will be greater than Cv, okay. So this is again a very important thing. So I hope the relationship between specific heats at constant pressure and constant volume is clear to you all, okay. Specific heat at constant pressure and volume is clear. Now we can move to another important thing, that is heat interaction in thermodynamic process, in thermodynamic process. What are heat interaction for different thermodynamic process? See, we have studied thermodynamic process, basically 5 thermodynamic process we have studied, isobaric, isochoric, isothermal, adiabatic, polytropic, right? So now we will find the heat interaction. What is the formula or what is the heat interaction for these process, okay? So firstly, before we start with heat interaction, I want to tell you one important thing, that is enthalpy. We are talking about heat, so you should know about one more important heat, which is enthalpy. What is enthalpy? See, enthalpy is known as the total heat content of the system. It is total heat content of the system, okay. So enthalpy is also a heat which is equal to total heat content of the system. This is denoted by H, which is equal to U plus PV, which is equal to U plus PV, because all the heat that goes into a system, what is? It is composed of work and internal energy. So this total heat, which is the sum of internal energy and the work, this work is known as flow work. This work is known as flow work, which is used for open system, okay, and this U is the internal energy. So combining these two terms will get you total heat content of the system. Total heat content of the system is equal to the sum of internal energy and the flow work, okay, and that is known as enthalpy. If this enthalpy is divided by mass, this will become specific enthalpy, that is small h, which is equal to u small u plus pv. This is known as specific enthalpy. Okay, so before we begin with the heat interaction, you should know what is enthalpy, because enthalpy is also the total heat content of the system. Okay, so the first process that we are going to study is isobaric process. What is the heat interaction for isobaric? That is constant pressure process. See, from the first law of thermodynamics, you have covered first law of thermodynamics. We know that del Q is equal to du plus pdv, right? Del Q is equal to du plus pdv, that is heat transfer is equal to sum of internal energy plus pdv work. Okay, and we can also say that this is equal to delta W, that is the work. This is first law of thermodynamics for a process. Okay, but the process right now is isobaric process, and we have just seen that in case of constant pressure process, the heat which is supplied goes into increasing the internal energy and doing some work. Now, this work which is done by displacement of the boundary is actually one work is due to displacement of the boundary, and some other work which is due to, which is composed of external work. What is this external work? When the work is done by the boundary, there is some air which is surrounding the cylinder. Now, this work will, some work will also be done by the, due to expansion, some work will be done on the surrounding also. Okay, some work will be done on the surrounding also. So, this work will be sum of this work minus the surrounding work or the external work. When this work will come here, this will be del Q plus del W external or surrounding is equal to du plus del W. Okay. Now, this total work, this total, we know that this is equal to del W is equal to pdv. So, you can write it as du plus pdv. Okay, because work done is going into displacement of the boundary. So, this del W will be equal to pdv, because boundary is getting displaced in case of isobaric process. We have just seen when we I talked to you about Cp and Cv, why Cp is greater than Cv. There I told you that in case of isobaric process, work is done to displace of boundary. Okay, to displace the boundary. So, work done will be equal to pdv work. So, this del Q will be equal to d times of u plus pv. If this surrounding work is neglected, we say there is no work done on the surrounding. Okay, so this del Q, which is at heat transfer at constant pressure, will be equal to du plus pv. What is u plus pv? I have just told you u plus pv is equal to enthalpy. Okay, so that means heat transfer at constant pressure is equal to in change in enthalpy, and this is equal to mcp dt, mcp dt. So, heat transfer at constant pressure is equal to change in enthalpy is equal to mcp dt. Okay, so this is a very important thing. Heat transfer at constant pressure is equal to change in enthalpy. Okay, so this is a very important relation. Next process is isochoric process. Isochoric means constant volume process. Very simple. Isochoric process. See, isochoric means constant volume. So, constant volume, I have told you this For a constant volume process, work done will be zero because there will be no displacement of the boundary. So, all the heat that goes into the system at constant volume will be equal to change in internal energy, and this is equal to mcv dt. Okay. So, heat transfer at constant volume is equal to change in internal energy, which is equal to mcv dt. Okay. Next process is isothermal process. Isothermal process. So, first law of thermodynamics for isothermal process, del Q is equal to du plus del W. Now, this is isothermal process. We know that for an isothermal process, what happens? Temperature is constant, right? And du, change in internal energy, this is equal to mcv dt, right? So, if temperature is constant, dt will be equal to 0. So, this term will be equal to 0. So, that means in case of isothermal process, net heat transfer is equal to net work transfer. For this process only, for this particular process, isothermal process, the heat transfer for this process is equal to work. So, all the heat goes into work for isothermal case. Okay, so this is very important thing. Heat interaction in isothermal process equal to total work interaction, right? Let's move on to the next process. This is very important. You have to remember this. Okay, this can be asked in the exam, that for an isothermal process, all the heat goes into work. Next is adiabatic process. What about adiabatic process? Adiabatic process. Adiabatic process. See, in the adiabatic process, whenever this adiabatic process comes in your exam or comes in front of you, you have to remember only one thing. Heat transfer is equal to 0 for an adiabatic process. That is, Q is equal to 0. Heat transfer is equal to 0 for an adiabatic process. You have to remember this thing. Okay. Well, for the practical cases, a process is not adiabatic. You have to make it adiabatic. How? Because a process can be made, heat transfer can be 0 only in two cases. When the temperature difference is 0 or when the system is insulated. When system is insulated. Okay. So, these are the two cases when heat transfer can be equal to 0. To achieve the adiabatic process, we actually insulate the system. We make sure that there is no heat transfer taking place. So, most of the devices like turbines and compressors, nozzle, they are made insulated. They are made insulated so that there is no heat transfer. Okay. So, such are devices are called adiabatic devices, okay, in where heat transfer is equal to 0. And how it is made 0? By making them completely insulated, making sure that heat transfer will not take place. Okay. So, for adiabatic process, heat transfer is equal to 0. You have to remember this. Okay. And the last process is polytropic. Polytropic process. This is important. This is important. Most of the cases, I have told you that most like equation of adiabatic is similar to polytropic. But in this case, for heat interaction, this is not the case. Heat interaction for polytropic is different as compared to for adiabatic. For adiabatic, it is equal to 0. But for polytropic, it is not the case. Okay, so what is the case in case of polytropic? In the polytropic process, del Q is equal to du plus del W. right? We have seen that polytropic work is equal to P1 V1 minus P2 V2 over N minus 1. So, del Q will be equal to du. What is du? MCV dt plus del W, which is equal to P1 V1 minus P2 V2 over N minus 1, right? What is this CV? I have just told you in this lecture, CV is equal to R over gamma minus 1. Okay, so this will be equal to M times R over gamma minus 1 into dt plus P1 V1 minus P2 V2 over N minus 1. Okay, so this dt can also be written as MR T2 minus T1 over gamma minus 1 plus P1 V1 minus P2 V2 over N minus 1. Okay. I have told you about this, that we know that PV is equal to MRT. So, if MRT2 minus T1 can be written as P2 V2 minus P1 V1 gamma minus 1 plus P1 V1 minus P2 V2 over N minus 1. After taking P1 V1 minus P2 V2 over gamma minus 1 common, you will get if you take this common P1 V1 minus P2 V2 over N minus 1, you will left with gamma minus N over gamma minus 1. Okay. So, this will be the heat transfer that you will get after solving this equation, after taking P1 V1 minus P2 V2 common. So, you will get this. So, heat transfer in case of polytropic process is equal to, see, what is this? This is work transfer in case of polytropic process, right? So, this is equal to work transfer in polytropic process into gamma minus N over gamma minus 1. Okay. So, you have to remember this thing, that heat transfer in case of polytropic process is equal to work transfer in case of polytropic process into gamma minus N over gamma minus 1. This is very, very important. This is very important. Very, very important. Okay, you have to remember this. Now, what conclusion can be drawn from this equation, that heat transfer in case of polytropic is equal to work transfer in case of polytropic into this factor? If we closely have a look at this factor, here gamma and N are given, gamma and N are given. The value of gamma is equal to, most of the gases is equal to 1.4, right? For diatomic gases, it is equal to 1.4. Okay. What is the N? Value of N is, we know that N is greater than 1 and less than gamma, right? So, suppose that if gamma is 1.4, value of N will be less than 1.4. Let us take this value as 1.3. Let us take this value as 1.3. And putting this value here, what you will get? You will get that del Q is equal to 1 by 4 times of del W polytropic, or we can say that work done in polytropic process is 4 times heat. So, what conclusion we have, we can draw from here? In case of polytropic process, the work which is the heat supplies almost equal to 4 times of heat in case of polytropic process. For polytropic process, work exceed heat which is supplied. Work transfer exceed the heat which is supplied to the system. Okay. That means whatever heat you are going to system, it the system is doing more work as compared to heat which is supplied. Four times heat supplied, the system is doing work. Okay. So this is a very, very important relation. You have to remember this equation. This is very, very important. Okay. That is heat transfer in polytropic process is equal to work transfer in polytropic process into gamma minus n over gamma minus 1. The last thing is, what is specific heat? The specific heat of polytropic process is also different as compared to other specific heat. There is a term called polytropic specific heat. Polytropic specific heat. What is this polytropic specific heat? Let us see. What we have got from here, that del Q polytropic heat transfer in polytropic process is equal to P1 V1 minus P2 V2 over N minus 1 into gamma minus N over gamma minus 1. We can write it as like this, MR T1 minus T2, because PV is equal to MRT, so we can write it as MR T1 minus T2 over N minus 1 into gamma minus N over N minus 1, right? Sorry, gamma minus N. If you take this gamma minus 1 here and N minus 1 here, what you will get? MR T1 minus T2 over gamma minus 1 into gamma minus N over N minus 1. Okay? Now, just look at it carefully. T1 minus T2, we know that temperature difference is equal to T2 minus T1, right? T2 minus T1. So, T1 minus dT will be equal to T1 minus T2. Simple thing. Okay? So, if you put it here, it will be MR minus dT over gamma minus 1 into gamma minus N over N minus 1. From here, I am writing it right at this place. See, R over gamma minus 1 is equal to CV, right? Into minus dT gamma minus N over N minus 1. Okay. And this is the heat transfer in case of polytropic process. We can represent like this also. Okay. So we can also write it as MCV, this as M minus CV times of gamma minus N over N minus 1 dT. Heat transfer is equal to this M times of minus CV gamma minus N over N minus 1 into dT. What is this term? What is this term? This complete term is known as polytropic specific heat. It is known as polytropic minus CV times of gamma minus N over N minus 1. This is known as polytropic specific heat. Okay? This is known as polytropic specific heat. You have to remember this. And this polytropic specific heat, you can see, it is always a negative quantity. It is a negative quantity. Okay. So, polytropic specific heat is always a negative quantity. Okay. why it is negative? If it comes in your exam, why it is negative? Why? Because in the case of polytropic process, the heat, although heat is supplied to a system, work transfer is exceeding the heat transfer. Work transfer is exceeding the heat transfer. So, although heat is supplied to a system, temperature is decreasing or internal energy will decrease. Okay. So, in the case of polytropic process, since heat transfer, work transfer is exceeding the heat transfer, the internal energy will decrease although heat is supplied to a system. So, if internal energy will decrease, this term will be negative. Okay. That is, polytropic specific heat will be negative. So, you have to remember only this thing. That is, polytropic specific heat is negative. And why negative? Because work transfer is greater than heat transfer in case of polytropic process. Okay. So, these were heat interaction for different thermodynamic process. Now, one important relation known as Mayer's relation. Okay. What is Mayer's relation? Mayer's relation is Cp minus Cv is equal to R. Okay. Difference of specific heat is equal to gas constant. I have told you this when I was telling you relationship between Cp and Cv, that difference in specific heat is equal to gas constant. Okay. So, let us prove it. We know that H is equal to U plus PV. Okay. So, differentiating both sides, you will get dH is equal to dU plus PdV. dU plus PdV. So, writing it like this, you will get mCp dT is equal to dU. What is dU? It is mCv dT. And this will be written as mR of dT, mR dT, okay, PdV is equal to mR dT, okay. So, from here, m will get cancelled out, you will get Cp minus Cv is equal to R, okay. This is very simple, difference of specific heat at constant pressure and constant volume is equal to gas constant, okay. That is called as Mayer's relation. That is known as Mayer's relation. Now, one more thing, that H is equal to U plus PV. Okay, U plus PV. H, this U is equal to mCv dT. Okay. And PV is equal to mRT. So, from here you will get that H is a function of temperature. That is, enthalpy is a function of temperature only. Enthalpy is a function of temperature. And you, for an ideal gas, for an ideal gas, enthalpy is a function of temperature. Okay. And same applies to internal energy also. Internal energy is also a function of temperature, because dU is equal to mCv dT. Okay. So, U is a function of temperature only for an ideal gas. For an ideal gas. So, you have to remember these things also. These are very, very important. Okay. These are very, very important, that internal energy is a function of temperature only for an ideal gas, and enthalpy is also a function of temperature for an ideal gas. Okay. So, this is all from the topic of heat. Okay. Today we have learnt about heat interaction for different thermodynamic process. I hope that this lecture is useful to you, because heat is a very important topic in thermodynamics also, not just only in heat transfer. Heat is also a very important topic in thermodynamics. and you need to understand what is heat interaction for different thermodynamic process. Okay, so I hope this lecture is clear to you. I have tried to clarify your doubts regarding heat transfer, what is heat transfer for different thermodynamic process. Okay.